Hey yo everybody and very welcome to the StarCraft 2 Crazy Replay, where today we have a TVT on Archon mode. That's the game I wanted to definitely show you. Hooray! And we have two guys, as said, that's Archon mode, TVT on Cerulean 4, whatever that is. In the bottom left hand side, in blue, as the Terran, we have Fame and Lol M. And in the top right hand side, in the red, also Terran, it's me, Alex and Frui. Yep, those are the short ones. Looks like everyone gets 4 digits for its name. So they are playing Rex Gas and we are playing Gas Rex. However, our Rex is almost as fast as theirs, so they are not playing that well currently. Interesting to note. And on that map, I want to show you the awesome move I just played there, which I was so proud of, I need to show it to someone. And because it's Archon mode, as you can see, it's not something I just made up. I really did it. There's one SCV being annoying, which always happens in Archon mode. It really happens all the time. Like, I'm not doing it, probably I just sprayed there the Terran decoy, the decoy, whatever. Thingy. Portray, I don't know. The spray. Yep. And we are scouting a little bit here. This marine, however, might be able to kill the SCV, or maybe not. Yep, he gets it, and he gets out there himself, which is nice. So the Reaper's on the way, the expansion's on the way. Ours are a little bit slower than theirs. He walks in, however, that's... it looks... Oh no, it's fine. It looked a little bit off, but I think it's fine. There we have the factory, no second guess for me so far, for us I have to say, let's be guess for them as well. So, Rex factory, Rex factory, everything standard. There's some random ping from me, in-game, not right now. If I would ping now, it's white. As you can see. Can I shift ping? No. I can't. Sadly, I cannot. So, a second guess being taken on both sides. See, there's another ping from me in game where I try to explain something. I don't know what exactly, but it is something. Starport comes down from me and us. That's weird. Widowmine as well. And yeah, it's TVT, so anything can happen. So far, it's a very macro oriented opening, which I like, but it also can be a slugfest. So, you never know, sometimes it's really a pain to play this game in TVT. We are getting a tech lab on the factory. They also have it because they skipped the Widowmine and the Hellion and the Cyclone and whatnot, so they immediately go into tank. Our tank will be late. Yeah, kill the unbuildable rocks, destroy them. Also don't get supply capped, so we need a depot very early, very soon. They get theirs, we don't get ours, which is a little bit frustrating. And we have the minerals. Where is it? There's the gas. The depot is super late. It is too late. For those marines, for the tank, it's too late. So we are supply capped, and that's annoying because we are playing with two people on one base race. So, being supply capped there is really bad stuff. However, we are scouting a little bit out. He's taking... They are taking a third base. And some weird fire alarm is going on. And I don't know if that's a good sign or not. And there it's off again, so probably no fire in our house or living room or apartment or whatever. So that's good. I won't burn alive while I'm casting, and I appreciate that a lot. So our base later than theirs and not on position, so we will be behind in that regard. We get however the Raven. And yeah, that's nice. It's a little bit late, but against Banshees or even against Marines, In Marine vs. Marine battle, if you can't get the big chunk of Marines and throw the anti-armor missile in there, can win you the game. Just imagine being in a... Because in mirror matchups, if you have the same army, positioning is important. Oh god. And of course, upgrades. And if you can erase 3 armor on the Marines, that's really huge. I don't know if this... Okay, it's off again. Maybe someone was showering and now all the steam is triggering the fire alarm, I don't know. So he's scouting around here. I don't know where the Widow Mine is. Okay, it's back there now. So this looks like a big attack coming our way. This tank is not doing much here anymore. He takes a lot of damage here with his Marines. Trying to kill something, not gonna happen. He scans, and it looks like we will lose. Oh no! We have done it. We cleared that, and as you can see, the army lost shows PR in favor. We lost one tank and 9 Marines and a Reaper against a Medivac, 3 tanks and 12 Marines. So that's value for us. Our stim, however, is very late. I don't know why they attacked there. They don't seem to have stim either. But the third base is up and running halfway, so props to them. Always repair your units if you can, that's so important. Can't stress out enough how important it is to repair your units. Do it. It doesn't cost much. Rebuilding costs way more. Just do it. Just repair them. Finally, our base is done. But we don't have too many SUVs. We are down 5 SUVs, which is bad. Upgrade wise, we are not looking solid either. Our eBay is just now finishing. Super late. So, in terms of macro, they are ahead. And that can win you the game, as I said. Being ahead in upgrades and army, if you play the same style, with the same race, is definitely bad for you. So don't do that, okay? I don't like this lone liberator. I mean, it can work, but maybe 4 Marines would be better off here, in my opinion. But yeah, they go up to 5 racks, which we already have, so that's where we can pounce back into the game, or bounce back, whatever. We get the sensor turret, which is super important. Spread the Marines, get the vision, don't use the all army hotkey. And there we go, some drop coming, as it looks like, probably not. We can scout the fourth base. Yeah, there's the ping. Whoop-de-doo, fourth base, which we of course don't really have. No, we get the armory, which is important. They have the armory already, could get 2-2 if they have the income and the minerals and so forth. Here are 4 medics full of units. The turrets are just now getting produced. And this could be really difficult. I guess we saw it. Oh yeah, we did. That's a good thing if you watch, if you play with 2 guys on one race, you just see way more. And there comes the interception part, where we tried to do it. And now comes what I wanted to show you, so be aware. He goes in, there comes the medevacs, into the turret, and he wants to unload, and... You know what happened there? One word. Interference matrix. And that was so close. I loved it. Just imagine all those units would have unloaded right here. Stimmed Marines with tanks there, and we out of position need to cramp up the ramp. Oh no. But this is why I would love to see the Raven more often in TVT, even if you don't play mech, because the interference matrix is so strong. You can't attack or use abilities for 8 seconds, and unloading or loading up a medivac is an ability. So here we go now, big attack. I think we just have way more stuff, because as you can see, they lost way more resources here. In total, they lost so much stuff there that they can't probably win this anymore. And I would say that's potentially game. They will lose the space, every single SCV there will die. And from that point on, That is just GG. So the Raven is not just for the turrets good. Actually, Interference Matrix is one of the most strong abilities in this game, I would say. It only can target mechanical and psionic units, but yeah, all important units you want to block are either mechanical or psionic, so this is a perfect spell. And they lost the space, there's not much to do, they can clear all that stuff if they desire, which they do. However, yeah, we get another tank here. It's now they have the upgrade advantage, as I said, but they took so much damage here that I don't think they can come back here. Not really. We also have the luck to scout this base now, while taking our own. And now we are on 8 barracks with 2 factories and 1 starport, which is, I would say, it's the ideal setup. And here we are attacking. This medivac might die. However, they are so far behind. So we killed almost 50 SCVs. That's huge. And I don't know if we can lose it. We get another factory here and some more factories, barracks, because why not? If you're ahead, keep ahead, stay ahead, and just get more production. This base will fall, and actually I think they should be able to just GG out. There's not much they can do here, to be honest. Maybe we can drop into the main base. I don't know for what we decide. Looks like we just pull back because we dealt so much damage. That is risky. Losing those tanks is risky and stupid. So that should never happen. Big mistake out of our part. But then still, even then we are ahead quite by a lot. And at some point there will just be the last push. I still think it's impressive that they stick with their upgrades onto us now, so that's nice, but that should be game. I mean, how do they want to win this? We just have so much more. Clumping up there is really bad, but they don't have much, and there's where he left the game and where we should just win. GG. So thank you so much for watching. I wanted to show you that exact move because it was so close. And with that said, I hope you enjoyed. As always, I wish you a very nice day and goodbye. Hey yo there, thank you for watching. If you'd like to support me, simply hit the thumbs up button. Do you have any wishes, feedback or suggestions? Put them into the comments below. You may also subscribe if you're new to the channel. I wish you a wonderful and stress-free day. Take care. Bye bye. Thank you.